we generally would do an MRI of the prostate first. And that MRI gives us nice definition and characteristics of the prostate size and shape, the potential location of the disease within the prostate. It helps us determine if there's some things that might give us problems later on. And so we do a careful evaluation ahead of time. If they're deemed to be a candidate, then on the day of the procedure, the patient is first brought to the operating room and an epidural catheter is put in their back. So an epidural is similar to what women that are giving birth when they get, you know, they'll have a anesthetic that will keep them numb from their belly button down. And that allows us to then put the patient to sleep very comfortably. And then we put their legs up in stirrups and we're going to use the skin right in front of the rectum and behind the scrotum. There's a little patch of skin there and we call that the perineum. And so this is called a transperineal HDR, temporary HDR brachytherapy. So then we would place needles or catheters, we prefer to call them, into that tissue, and it's right where we can access the prostate. We also put a catheter in the bladder. And so this process takes probably about an hour and a half or so in the operating room to carefully place the needles in the location. I'll go over an example of how we do that. Once the needles are placed in the location and the catheters are exactly where we want them, then we wake the patient up and of course they've got the epidural in and they've got a little button that's keeping them numb so they're not feeling any pain. And then we bring them down to our department and we do a very careful CT scan. The CT scan gives us a three-dimensional picture of the implant, we call it, so the catheter position, where the prostate is, and where the critical structures are. So we want to avoid the bladder, we want to avoid the rectum, and try to localize the radiation just to where we want it. So this machine is called a remote afterloader. And this is kind of really the nuts and bolts of what allows us to do this type of therapy nowadays. So this is the state-of-the-art, newest generation afterloader, or remote afterloader. So it's essentially a robotic treatment device, and it's got within it a tiny little radiation source. It's called iridium, and it's welded on the end of a wire. And that wire is housed in here and kind of coiled up inside of a protective area, so we're not getting any radiation right now, even though there is a source inside. When the patient's ready to be treated, then the catheters are in the patient get connected up to these transfer tubes, and then the machine, having been pre-programmed, will be able to send a radiation source down the different channels. So for instance, here would be channel one. It would send the radiation source down the channel, and then there would be a tube. This would be the catheter that would be put in the patient, for instance. The source would run down the end of the tube, and it would sit right there for a few seconds, and then be able to pull back and sit there for a few seconds and pull back for a few seconds and a few seconds, as long as it's been programmed to do. And then once it gets to the end of the prostate, so this might be the top part of the prostate and then the bottom part, it would get all the way through and then it would come out. So it's given all the radiation it needs to in that location. So then it would channel, or would switch to channel number two and then come out into channel number two and do the same process. It's not going to sit in the exact same positions because it's a different location within the prostate, but essentially there's a grid that then gets treated that includes the whole prostate.